Good morning, dear students. Today in this lecture, lecture number 76, we are going to start a new topic, chapter number 15 in your pencil book, letter writing. Okay, if you know English very well, if you now have a good command over the language English, now you should start writing letters to your friends, your relatives. Okay, just like the application which you write to your class teacher or principal sir for asking leave from school. So these are the forms of letter. Your application is also a form of letter. It is a written message to given someone for informing something. Okay, so letter writing today we are going to start. What is letter? Okay, first we discuss what is letter. Letter is a written message written. Okay. Letter is a written message which is sent to someone, which is sent to someone. Suppose if I want to give you some written message, I write a letter and I will post it to you through post office or through courier. It will come to your address and you can read that message. Usually in an envelope and by post. Usually how do we send the letter? First we write a message on a paper, then we fold it, and after folding it we keep into a envelope and we paste by a glue. Okay, we apply some glue and we paste it, pack the envelope, and after packing the envelope, on one side we write the address of the receiver to whom we want to send this letter. Suppose if I want to send you this letter, so I should write the address of your house, so that the courier boy or the post office, the postman, he can reach to your address and he can give it to you. Okay, so on the front side of the envelope I write your address, the receiver's address. I am the sender and you are the receiver. Okay, if I am writing this letter to you, so receiver's letter is written on the front side of the envelope and envelope is packed. So generally we send this type of written messages by writing on one blank paper and we fold it and we keep it inside the envelope and we fold the envelope, we paste the envelope, and after packing the envelope we write the address of the receiver on the envelope and then we post it into post office or through courier. So this is what letter writing is done. In your school, when you sent any application, so you sent that application not by the postman but through your friends, your neighbors. If your friend is living nearby your house, you can give that letter to him without envelope. Okay, and he sent that he brings that envelope to your class teacher or your principal sir. Okay, so this is how the letters are used. Now, kinds of letters. What are the different type of letters? Kinds means types of letter. Generally, we have two types of letters, two kinds of letter. One kind is personal letters or social letters. Means there are two names for the same. Personal letters, which we write personally to our friends or relatives. Okay, this is written to our friends or relatives. So when we write the letter to our nearer one, very close one, our friends or relatives, there is no need to do any formalities. We directly, we can talk and we can share our personal things in these letters. So that's why it is called personal. Or social letter, because we write this letter to our society, means friends and relatives, they are the part of our society. So that's why it is called social letters. One more thing, it is also called informal letters. Okay, so first we understand what is formal letters. One is personal or social letter and second are formal or business letter. Formal letters are written on the offices, government offices, private offices, or to any traders, dealers, bookkeepers, book store holders, newspapers, the editor of the newspapers, these all private or government offices. When we write a letter, just like to collector, to SDM, to SP of your area, collector, to the principal, when you write the letter or application to your principal, sir, that is also a formal type of letter. Or business persons, those who are involved in the business and they have their offices, we post the letter to the regarding their business. So these are called business letters or formal letters. Here we require to fulfill the formalities also. We should use the language, very formal language and polite language here. And here, but it is the reverse of these. In reverse of the formal, personal or social letters, they don't need any formality. Directly we can share anything personally, direct to direct. Our personal feelings we can also share here. So that's why they are called personal letters or informal letters. The opposite of formal is informal. Informal letters, in this formal letters you need to do formalities, but in informal letters you need not to do any formalities. So friends or relatives, when you write these letters, these type of letters to your friends and relatives, and these type of letters are written to your offices, government, whether it is a government offices or private offices. So all offices, when you write any offices like collector, superintendent of police, TI or town inspector, these are the government officials. Or private offices also you can take. Business, any business offices or any editor of newspaper, editor newspapers, to your class teacher or principal, means to your schools, schools, colleges, coachings, when you write the letter to them, dealers, traders. So these are called business formal letters or business letters. So this is the difference between these two letters. So now let's we have a different parts of letters. To discuss these parts of letters, I need to note down one letter on the board. Then we will discuss the different parts of these letters. So first I need to note down the letter which is given on page number 62. You are living in a hostel. Write a letter to your father. When you are living in hostel means you are far away from your house. So when you are living in hostel and you wanted to write a, to send a message to your parents or your father, you should write a letter. Him to send you some money. You require some money. So that's why you are writing a letter. You are sending this message to your father that please send me some money. I require some money to meet your expenses. To meet my expenses, mere kharchon ko pura karne ke liye, to satisfy my expenses, because I have to do some expenses, very urgent expenses. So I require some money, so please send me some money. So this type of message you wanted to convey to your parents or your father. So what the, that example is already given, but we are going to discuss the format. So for discussing the format of that letter, I need to clean the board. So let me note down this letter on the board. So this is the format of a letter, example of a letter which is given on your page number 62. But before we read this letter, first we read this letter. What is written there? First the name of the hostel. So suppose by my mind or by my imagination I have written room number 15. By imagination you can write anything, because in hostels we generally have different number of rooms. suppose in this room two students are living, in that room number 16 other students are living, so you are allotted some rooms in the hostel. Okay, so room number 15 suppose, and the name of the hostel is, I suppose that Vivekananda Hostel, Tagore Hostel, Mahatma Gandhi Hostel, and these type of great people, generally the names of the hostels are placed, and the name of the city, Lucknow. So this is the address. Okay, whose address is this? The writer's address comes first. Means if I am writing the letter, so my address will come here, because to whom I am sending the letter, suppose I am writing this letter to my father, so my father's address should be on the envelope. वो तो लिफाफे के ऊपर लिखूंगा ना मैं, क्योंकि पोस्टमैन उस एड्रेस पे जाके देगा. पर मेरा एड्रेस कहाँ होगा? सबसे पहले राइटर का एड्रेस, सेंडर्स एड्रेस मैं भेज रहा हूं. सो माय एड्रेस शुड कम हियर, रूम नंबर, हॉस्टल नेम, सिटी. ओके, दिस इज माय एड्रेस, सेंडर्स एड्रेस. सो योर एड्रेस यू कैन राइट बाय योर सेल्फ, योर एड्रेस. व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग लेटर यू कैन राइट योर एड्रेस. ओके, इन प्लेस ऑफ लखनऊ यू शुड राइट खरगोन. So this is the margin. Suppose this is your page. Okay, your page is ending here. So we have 1 inch gap and we put a margin. Okay, we put a margin like that, or it is already put in your exam notebook. Okay, if it is not there, take 1 inch margin, and all the new lines should begin with here, with this margin. Okay, all the new line should begin attached to this margins. Okay, now your address, you should not write the address in a long line. No, the half of the page, this is your half of the page, so don't cross the half of the page. You should break your address. Suppose your address is up to here, suppose your address is so long, so you can break into some three small pieces. So one piece room number, second piece name of the hostel, comma, and the name of the city, then full stop. Within three half line you should complete your address. Then leave one line blank for gap, then note down the address of today when you are writing this letter. Suppose today is 24th April 2020, so put today's date, any date, whenever you have your question paper, your exam, you can write that date also. Then again leave one line gap. Then this is called salutation. Salutation means how you greet, how you wish to the person to whom you are writing letter. Suppose you are writing this letter to your father, so how would you greet him? My dear father, good morning, good afternoon, anything, or namaste. Okay, anything. But in the English letter we don't do this, we only write this, my dear father, comma, leave that line blank, and wherever this salutation finish, my dear father, comma, then come to the line below line, and just here start your new line with capital letter. I am leaving. Okay, leave the first line, come to second line, but from where father ends, you start this new paragraph from here. I am living in the hostel quite comfortably. आई एम लिविंग इन द हॉस्टल क्वाइट कम्फर्टेबली, मैं बहुत अच्छे आराम से रह रहा हूँ. डोंट वरी अबाउट मी, मेरे लिए बिल्कुल भी चिंता मत करो. आई हैव रिसीव्ड योर लेटर, मुझे आपका लेटर मिल चुका है, एंड बैंक ड्राफ्ट टूडे, और साथ में बैंक ड्राफ्ट भी मिला है. नाउ व्हाट इज बैंक ड्राफ्ट? ओके, बैंक ड्राफ्ट मीन्स, बैंक ड्राफ्ट इज अ फैसिलिटी थ्रू विच यू कैन सेंड द मनी फ्रॉम वन पर्सन टू other person. Okay, bank draft means check, just like bank check if you have seen. So if you go to bank and you show that check, the cashier will give you the money in return of that check, so that is called bank draft. Okay, so I have received your letter and bank draft today. Aaj mujhe aapka letter bhi mila aur bank draft bhi mil gaya. The money sent by you is not sufficient. The money sent by you through this bank draft is not sufficient. पर्याप्त नहीं है, इतने में पूरा नहीं होगा. To meet my expenses, क्योंकि मेरे खर्चे ज्यादा हैं. So that is not sufficient. I require more money. I am in urgent need for some more money immediately. I require some more money. That is not sufficient. Besides the school fees and hostel fees. Besides school and hostel fees. मतलब school और hostel fees के अलावा. Besides means के अलावा. इन दो फीस के अलावा I also have to buy a few books. And a coat. I have to buy a few books. मुझे खरीदना है. Buy means खरीदना भी है. कुछ नई किताबें खरीदना है. A few books and a new coat. और एक coat भी खरीदना है. I think rupees 2000 should be enough to cover these expenses. I think that rupees 2000 should be enough. बहुत पर्याप्त होंगे अगर आप 2000 और भेज दें तो. इनफ टू कवर दीज एक्सपेंसेस, द एक्सपेंसेस ऑफ बुक्स एंड कोट. आई थिंक 2000 विल बी सफिशियंट. आई होप इट विल नॉट बी इनकन्वीनियंट टू यू इन एनी वे. आई होप, मुझे उम्मीद है, मुझे आशा है कि आपको इससे कोई असुविधा नहीं होगी. असुविधा मीन्स इनकन्वीनियंट. मुझे लगता है कि 2000 भेजने में आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होनी चाहिए. इन एनी वे, होपिंग फॉर क्विक रिप्लाई. होपिंग, होपिंग मीन्स आपकी उम्मीद कर रहा हूं मैं. फॉर योर क्विक रिप्लाई मीन्स इफ आई, एज सुन एज यू विल गेट माई लेटर यू विल रिप्लाई मी. ओके, आई एम सेंडिंग यू द मनी और आई कैन नॉट सेंड यू मनी, वट एवर योर रिप्लाई. आई होप दैट यू विल रिप्लाई मी क्विक, फास्ट. सो आई एम होपिंग फॉर योर क्विक रिप्लाई. Now, this is called the body of letter. Whatever is contained in the main topic which is for which the letter is written, that is called the body of the letter. Then, the subscription or what is your faithfully, it is called subscription. Your faithfully, your sincerely, your loving son, your affectionately, these all are called subscriptions. So you should write the subscription. Then your name, and above your name you can make a signature also. Suppose your name is Naveen, so this is your signature and your name Naveen. And if you have any designation, designation means post. Suppose you are on the designation of the monitor. So you can write your designation post also here. Sports secretary, school head boy, school head girl, like that you can also write your designation here. And the address, address you should write on the receiver's address to whom you are writing the letter, that address should appear on the envelope. Okay, on the top of the envelope. So this is the letter. Now come back to page number 61. Now come back, return to page number 61. Now we need to discuss the different parts of the letter. The form of a letter. This is a form of a letter, format of a letter. This is how the letter is written. What is the different parts of this letter? First is heading. This is called heading. Heading of the letter. Okay, this is heading. It includes, what does include in the heading? It includes place and date of letter writing. Means you require, you, this contains the date also up to here. Okay, address or the place on which or at which the letter is written, and the date on which the letter is written, time and place where the letter is written, that is called heading of the letter. Salutation, this is salutation. My dear father, my dear mother. Okay, so this is salutation. Various forms of greetings like dear brother, dear sir. Okay, dear father, dear mother, dear grandfather. This is the salutation. Then the body of letter, whatever the letter, the main purpose for which the letter is being written, that is called the body of the letter. These all paragraph is called body of the letter. Then subscription, this is called subscription. Okay, when you end the letter, you are going to end the letter, you write about yourself, that your loving son, aapka pyara beta, your affectionately, aapka bahut priya. Okay, like that. Your faithfully, aapka bahut vishwas patra, ya your sincerely, aapka bahut bharosemand, or ya phir your obediently, aapka aagyakari. So you can write subscription. It includes the polite expression for ending the letter. This is the for ending the letter. Your faithfully, your sincerely, etc. Signature. Now name and signature. It includes the name, signature, or designation. Designation means your post. If you are on the post of sports secretary, you can write here your post. Below your name, you can write your designation, and above your name, you can mark your signature. You can put your signature. And the address of the receiver, your father's address, you can write on the envelope. Okay, so this is the different parts of the letter. You should keep in your mind. This is called heading. This is called heading, place and date, place and time. Salutations means greeting, when you are greeting to the receiver of this letter. Then body of the letter, the main subject for which you are, the main purpose for which you are writing this letter. Then subscription, when you are going to end this letter politely. So one polite sentence should be used here. Your loving son, your affectionately, your dear. Then the last is signature. Signature includes name, designation and signature. In personal letters, we don't use any designation. So name and signature only in personal letters. Okay. So this is how we note down the, we write the letters. Okay. Now let's discuss the second letter, which is also given here. So let's discuss about the second example. Write a letter to a friend. Write a letter to a friend of you who is very sick, who is very ill, bimar hai, and being treated in a hospital. And he is being treated in a hospital. Uska ilaaj chal raha hospital mein. He is admitted in the hospital. So you need to write a letter asking his about his health, that how he is feeling now. So any of the disease you can write here, mention here. Okay, because the disease is not cause of the disease is not mentioned in the question, so you can take or imagine or guess by yourself any disease. Suppose here, so first thing, what, how should we start the letter? First we write the heading, and heading of the letter includes two things, place and time, means date. These two things are included in the, so on the left corner, upper left corner of the paper we begin. Okay, remember one thing, always begin writing a letter on a new page. Suppose in your question paper, if you have finished your answer up to here and you have only half paper, so don't start the letter writing from the half of the paper. You should move to the next page, and you should always start the paper on the from the top, means one full page of your answer script you should use for the letter writing. Don't start the letter from the half of the page. Leave that page or write any other answer on that page. But later, whenever you are writing later in your exam, So always begin with the top of the paper. Take a new fresh page and write, start writing here. So on the left, upper left side of the letter, you should start the address of yours. Sometimes in the question paper, address is already given. But if the already letter address is not given, you can write your own address, or by you can write any address by your mind. Suppose I have taken 22 Anand Nagar. 22 is the house number, then comma, Anand Nagar is a street or in the colony, just like Brajvihar colony, any colony you can take, comma, then the name of the city like Agra, or if you are writing your address, you can take Khargol. So within two or three lines, half lines, you should finish this address. Then leave one line blank. Give a break or give a gap between these two, then write today's date. Okay, so suppose I have taken 17th August 2020. Then again, we need to give one gap of one line. Then salutation. I am writing this letter to my friend Mohit. So I can start with Dear Mohit. My dear friend Mohit. Okay, any type of greeting you can use, but remember, you should start with the capital D, and names are always begins with capital letters. So dear, D is capital, Mohit, M is capital, then comma, then leave that line, come to the line below, and where the Mohit is ended, just start from here. Okay, this is how we change the paragraph. I am very, now this is what, the body of the letter, means main purpose of writing the letter. The main purpose is written here, why we are writing the letter. Main message is here, body of the letter, this is called body of the letter. I am very sorry. Whenever we hear any bad news, at that time we feel very very sorry. So I am very sorry to know that you have been admitted in the hospital. You have been admitted in the hospital. Your elder sister informed me. Your elder sister, aapki badi behan, she informed me that you were suffering from dengue fever. Okay, one type of fever which is spread due to the or through the mosquitoes. That is called dengue fever. Dengue fever is very common nowadays. Nowadays means in dinon, dengue fever bahut common ho chuka hai, har kisi ko ho raha hai, bahut tezi se phail raha hai. It is very common nowadays. It comes with acute pain in the joints. Joints, these are your joints of the bones. These are our joints. So when you suffer from the disease dengue, there is a severe pain, acute pain in your all joints. You suffer from the pain. So your joints start paining. This fever is spread owing to mosquitoes. This fever is spreading through which medium? Through the mosquitoes. I hope you will get well soon. I hope, मुझे उम्मीद है, मैं आशा करता हूँ, you will get well soon. Get well soon means आप अच्छे हो जाओगे. Well means बहुत अच्छे हो जाओगे. Soon, soon means जल्द ही. मैं इसे उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आप बहुत जल्दी ही ठीक हो जाओगे. I shall pray for your quick recovery. I shall pray to God for your quick recovery. भगवान से प्रार्थना करूँगा आप जल्दी से जल्दी स्वस्थ हो जाएं. Now, yours affectionately. Now this is salutation. How you are going to end the letter? Yours. Now you should start with capital Y. Yours. And we have S also. Yours. Aapka. But don't put any apostrophe. Don't put. Yours. Aapka. Affectionately. Priya. Aapka priya. Dost. Kon. Deepak. Your name. Name should be start with capital. This is also capital. This should be also capital. You can also initial here. You can also make a signature of Deepak like this. Above your name, you can put the signature. So this is signature and date, name and signature. So this is how you divide this later, but each and every line you should start with the margin. Okay, you should start with the margin. So this is how you note down the letter. These both of the two letters, one is written to father and the other is written to friend. So both are written to friends or relatives. So these are called informal letters, personal letters, social letters. But when we write the letter to any office, suppose you are writing to school office, suppose principal sir, class teacher, so these are the office formal places. Okay, so that type of letters are called business letters or formal letters. So that is not given here for your practice. Only informal letters are given, only personal letters are given, so you should practice these only. Okay, now some exercises you can also do by yourself, that write a letter to your friend inviting him to your sister's marriage. So these are fixed. This is fixed. You can copy as it is heading. Okay, then salutation, it is also same. You can write the your friend's name. Suppose your friend is Raj. So dear Raj, my dear friend Raj, dear friend Raj, anything you can write here. Then the body of the letter should be related to what is asked in your question. Write a letter to your friend inviting him for your sister's marriage. So you can start your letter like that. My dear friend Mohit, comma, then next line. How are you there? Aap kaise ho? I am fine here. Main to yahan achha hoon. So I am writing this letter to you. Main aapko ye letter isliye likh raha hoon because there is a marriage of my elder sister in the next month. Agle mahine mere badi behan ki shaadi hai. So I am inviting you for the marriage. The date of the marriage is this. Suppose any date you can write. You have written here 17th of August. So means in September. So on 12th of September. Okay, so there is a marriage at my home on 12th of September. My elder sister is going to get married. So I am inviting you here. All our other friends are also coming. So you should also join this family function. Okay, so now yours, or you can end with your letter that I will wait for you. Main aapka intezaar karunga. Okay, yours affectionately, yours loving friend, yours friend, now your name. So that is how you can end this letter. Write a letter to your younger brother scolding him for having neglected his studies. Suppose your younger brother, aapka chota bhai, wo kahin aur reh raha hai aur aap kahin aur reh rahe ho. So you can write scolding him, aap usko daato ki why are you neglecting your studies. Okay, write an application to the principal of your school requesting her to grant you sick leave for week. For a week. Aapko ek saptah ki chutti chahiye. Kaun si? Sick leave. Bimari ki chutti. Because you are sick. You are not feeling well. And your principal is her. Her is used for ladies or girls. So means your principal is ladies. Write an application to the headmaster requesting him to grant leave for a week as you are going to attend your cousin's marriage. So that is the same thing. So here you will write dear ma'am or dear sir, your house address, date, then dear sir, dear ma'am, I have to go with my family to attend my cousin's marriage. So I am unable to attend the school for next week. So please grant me 1 week. Leave. Your obediently, your sincerely, your faithfully, anything you can write, then your name and your signature. You can also mention your class here. Class 5th Diamond. Okay, that is how you finish this letter. So this written letter I will provide you in your WhatsApp group. So from there you can note it down in your notebook and prepare for your final exam. Okay, so here I am going to end this lecture. I hope that you have all understood this topic. well. Thank you very much.